Hey everybody, in today's video, I'm going to share with you some rather unique reasons why this is the perfect time to update your interior spaces, how to do that, and it doesn't have to cost you a thing. I'm excited to share with you some innovative ways and in how you can have more with less and still achieve a well-appointed interior space that doesn't have to be torn apart at the seams and turned upside down and that offers you results that can create a peaceful and restorative environment that ultimately nurtures you. And who doesn't need that? So if you're excited to hear what I have for you today, help keep this channel out there by please hitting the like, share, and subscribe buttons below. You know, I appreciate that. So there's no better time to make changes, as I see it, to your interior spaces than right now. And hear me out, because what I'm going to share with you doesn't have to cost you a thing, only takes a little imagination and a smidge of openness to wake up or energize your space to not only look better, but feel amazing for you too. And when your space feels good, you do as well. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Design Beyond the Visual, where I offer you a blend of conventional design wisdom, those aesthetic and functional elements that go into creating interior spaces. Well, what I'm most passionate about and also share with you are my Vastu tips that support, generate, and boost the positive energy flow for you in those interior spaces. I'm Heidi Smith, your decorating coach and energetic advisor for you, your home, and for your workplace spaces, and I'm here to help you. I'm here to empower you by giving you ways to create good Vastu design for your whole home or your whole space. And quickly, for those of you who might be new to the term Vastu, Vastu is an ancient science and wisdom that creates an energy, that feeling you get when you're in a space. And it's through very specific techniques and methods where we can amplify that sense of harmony and good health and bring that into our buildings, our homes, our workplace spaces, you know, those places that we live in and work from. You can think of it as yoga for the home, the yoga of design, or even the mother of feng shui. It's been around for over 10,000 years. So we all go through life changes. Some are, you know, really wonderful and, well, you know, others, less fun. Yet we all know we experience many highs and lows throughout the course of our lives. But what about this? How about making a change or two to your interior environments, your home or workplace spaces that actually represents an acknowledgement of those life changes? So here's the approach I'd like you to know before I talk specifics and the how and what you can do to enhance your interior spaces. When making changes to your physical spaces, I'm suggesting you do so with intention. You know, approach those changes and modifications, no matter how big or small, to reflect or represent anything from a celebration of to simply acknowledging a life change or shift for you. With an intention, you're creating something wonderful for, you know, who you are now and who you're becoming. And that matters. And that's powerful. It's a fresh look, I'm suggesting. Yeah, but it's more than that. It's really a fresh feel. So try thinking about your space, you know, in a different way, a way that sustains something deeper than just what meets the human eye. Intentionally create something meaningful. It could even represent a fresh start for you. So let's talk about the tactile ideas. My number one favorite thing to do in a space to enhance or boost the look and feel of my surroundings, and it's something I've been doing my entire life, and I mean way back since I was a small child, and it's quick, it's easy, it's cheap, doesn't have to cost you a thing. In fact, it doesn't cost you a thing. My favorite idea that I use to bring in more positive flow of energy is to alter the furniture arrangement. I love doing this. I have always enjoyed doing this. Your furniture placement has a big impact on the flow of energy in and around your interior spaces. And this placement can either positively or negatively impact you as well as others in the space. So imagine what it might look like to see your sofa or TV or chair on another wall or in another room, or perhaps here's a little bit more drastic action. What might it look like to see your sofa curbside? I mean, is it time to let great Aunt Betty's sofa go? Is it really worth hanging on to? I mean, everything has a shelf life, right? So has the shelf life of something you've been holding on to all these years expired and had its due? Or, you know, if it's in good condition, maybe it's time for someone else to enjoy it by donating it. The other thing is, you know, I realize many of us are living with a smaller footprint these days, and I happen to be in that category too. So you might feel you're limited in what you can do with your furniture arrangement, but you're only as limited as what you think you are, right? So even if your space is small, you can still make changes that can bring in a sense of renewal and an uplifting feeling. So if that is you, maybe you can shift the sofa to the left or the right a few inches. And that's about all the space I would have. And if you've got it pushed, if you have a sofa or any furniture for that matter, right up against the wall, ideally to be in Vastu compliance, we want to move it about 4 inches away from the wall so it doesn't pick up any geopathic stress. But, you know, that may sound silly to you, is an inch here or half an inch there, but, you know, what benefit would it be by creating, you know, a shift in furniture that's just that small? But it actually can be enough to take a space that is feeling stuck and stagnant to feeling more open and more expansive. And that's huge. So what if you just can't shift the furniture even a little bit? All right, no worries. Flip the cushions, fluff the cushions. Maybe you bring in something, you know, like a soft and feel good, you know, afghan or a throw or a quilt that complements, you know, your space. Something that feels comforting and looks inviting and has that nice weight to it so that when you wrap it around your shoulders or drape it over your legs, you know, it helps you feel grounded. You know, it helps you feel grounded in the space and gives you that really nice sense of luxury. You don't have to do a complete 180 shift of your furniture layout to feel a positive difference in your space. You know, updating or simplifying your interior environments doesn't have to be on a big scale to feel a big impact. So what matters is start by setting the intention to create a supportive space for where you are right now. All right. Does moving the furniture around sound too daunting for you? All right, so maybe for you, it's a new plant or fresh flowers or a change in the furniture layout, the room layout. Now, I'll tell you more about the room layout in part two of easy, unique, no-cost interior updates. That'll be coming out next week. I mean, you can make this as big as you want or keep it simple and start by just moving one single object. How about a fresh coat of paint or a new color of paint? Time for a fresh coat of paint on the walls, maybe the trim or even the ceiling. What about painting a piece of furniture? How about flipping through a paint fan or, looking at some inspiring wall or trim colors? That, you know, can feel uplifting too. So the planning part of it can feel really uplifting. You can pick up a fan deck. Well, when you can get back out to the stores, at hardware stores or paint stores, you probably can even order it from Amazon or from, you know, the individual paint stores online. So, you know, maybe there's a color that you run across that, you know, just makes your heart skip a beat or, you know, brightens your gaze. So, or how about, you know, is it time for new sheets or fresh towels? Even replacing, you know, ratty old dish towels you have. Maybe some colorful throw pillows. Maybe a new area rug. Any of these can create a wonderful sense of feeling re-energized and, you know, uplifted. So, you know what? No matter where you are in the story of your life, updating your interior space with a fresh look and feel can make all the difference in the world to your inner sphere. That space, which is you. renewing our home and workplace spaces can regenerate positive, uplifting feelings, not only for ourselves, but for others who may be in and around our spaces. You know, set an intention as you create good vastu to improve or refresh your environment, and you'll soon notice how it starts to positively affect how you cope or even how you view the world through your current lens. All sorts of wonderful things can happen when we are willing to consider making the existing space work for us in the way we now need it to work for us. And it doesn't have to cost much or anything at all. I thank you for joining me. Thank you for liking, sharing, and subscribing. It all supports this channel. And please let me know in the comments below how I can help you bring a deeper sense of connection to your homes and workplace spaces so that your day-to-day life is always and in all ways infused with beauty, brilliance, and balance. And it's easier than you think. I wish you all good vastu. Bye, everyone.